Well, as one thinks about the opportunities that are available today for young adults in the world of work, it's amazing how it's an opportunity for many to use their gifting. I think for me, the greatest ambition that anyone, whether young adult or otherwise, the greatest ambition is to be like Christ. You see, we are called to be witnesses, all of us. We are called to be representative and ambassadors of Christ wherever we are placed. And I think the greatest challenge, obviously, is how do I live out my life in the situation where God has placed me? The ambitious life, as I see it, is to be the salt and light where God has placed me. The light to show off the love of Christ, the light to lighten where there is darkness, in the way that you live out your Christian life. How pleasant it is when in the world of work, we find young adults and young people who are committed to the claims of Christ and just wholly and totally following his precepts, that they live out their life and they shine Christ in a world that is rotten. I mean, there are challenges that faces many young adults today, be moral issues, integrity issues. Now imagine if God has called you as a young adult and you've been skilled, you have a good education, a job that you have, and then you now have a responsibility as a young adult in that kind of a situation to live out the claims of Christ. You know, when I grew up, it used to be that if you are zealous and if you want to follow Christ, the only option that seemed to have been the one that was open for many was for you to sense God's call to Bible college, for an example, and to be the minister. And I think that's, we've passed that stage in saying that everywhere God has placed you, you are a missionary, you are a pastor, you are a Christian to shine out the claims of Christ. Now, my appeal would be how whatever ambition in life that you have, use it then to be a witness. Use it to be a springboard for the gospel message to others. Now, we do need to be aware, of course, that there is what I call good ambition, and also there is the side effect of it is an unhealthy. The unhealthy ambition is the one that says, oh, you know what? I just want to amass all the wealth and the material things in this world to the best I can. The unhealthy one is the one that says, I want to go to the top. You know, if I'm an accountant, I want to get right up there, regardless of the cost that is involved. And I think that is probably unhealthy. But I think as a Christian young adult who has been entrusted with you know, these wonderful skills that we have today, education, whatever it may be, I think it is good then to harness that ambition and say, God helping me with all the skills that I have, I am going to be the ambassador of Christ. I'm going to be the representative of Christ using all the skills, the knowledge, the know-how, the wisdom to represent Christ. So one needs then to be very careful then how you manage your ambition. Is it a healthy one? Well, to make it healthy, obviously, there are several things that you need to put into place. First, you really need a prayer life that is solely dedicated to God. So in your prayers, what are you praying for? I mean, in the Lord's Prayer, Jesus Christ says, the first thing that we call for is his kingdom must come. So if God has placed me in a situation, my ambition is to make sure that it is about him. So the kingdom has the king. So the king is the one that we focus on. What is it that God wants? What is it that he desires to do for me and through me? But I think the second thing is a habit of being committed to scriptures. You know, scripture then puts us and help us then to know the boundaries. As you reflect on scripture, as you, you know, get in and have your quiet times, that will be on an individual basis. As you join others in community where you read together the Bible, could be a Bible study or cell group, or whatever it is, you know, you create a habit of being in the Word, because the Word is going to guide you. It will help you once you see that your ambition is getting out of hand. But I think the third thing also is living in community. When you live in community, it's what scripture talks about it when it says iron sharpens iron. You'll have other people surrounding you where you can ask for advice sometimes and just say, oh, look, am I doing the right thing here? Am I being too forceful or too ambitious if I'm looking for this particular position? Because it's very easy to drift into what the world desires more than what God wants. So if you are committed and if your life is a life that is driven, obviously, by your prayer life, is driven by scripture, or at least guided directed by scripture, and then you're surrounded by peers also that are on fire for the Lord, you are likely then to be able to manage your ambition. So what is it that drives you? What is it that motivates you? And out of that, you'll begin to realize that, am I here to do God's will with all what God has given to me? And if it's outside his will, obviously it's unhealthy.